rolling. Magical self-unloading Impala. So we're gonna do something cool and drag the car off with the old GMC truck, but she decided to self-unload despite the flat tires. And it ran over the J-hook I had rigged up, and now it's on the ground and it's kind of just a mess. So the best thing for the car is for me to just tilt the deck down, get it off the ground, pull out from under it. It's in gear, it's gonna sit right where it's at. And I'll have plenty of old junk here to pull with an old car for another day, so. Put it in something.
30 weight.
cool.
This one must have been thirsty.
Pepsi Cola can.
Yeah.
Mountain Dew can.
Is that a Mountain Dew? The other one's Mountain Dew?
Yeah, that's the old one. All right, here's our save and all.
Thank you. cool.
Conditional sale contract. 1963,
60-year
check and bank accounts too. Even call Optima Tax Relief. The experts at Optima specialize in a powerful IRS tax assistance program called the Fresh Start Initiative.
Unless otherwise provided in the aftermarket. Is their fee only 25%? That's 40%. Every time, all the time, no matter the school.
ZipRecruiter.com/radio. ZipRecruiter doesn't depend on candidates finding you. It finds them for you. Its powerful technology identifies people with the right experience and actively invites them to apply to your job. You get qualified candidates fast. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you what you're...
Bonnie's roaming? I don't know. In close, you buy me this year will be very soon, very soon.
Yeah.
Compression fittings in here.
Yeah.
It's different.
Yeah. Oh, dude, way different. Here's your in.
Wait.
Yeah, there's your in. Here's your out. All right.
Yeah, all we need is a...
That might go ahead and screw in. Nope.
Okay. You need the fitting.
Yeah, that's different, man.
But I got my old brass fittings box. Has anything ever worked out of that thing yet?
Phil uses it all the time. I don't like it.
Where do you want to run this to?
It, that doesn't have to go anywhere. That's the vent.
Okay, that's
fine. In a yeah, boat, you need this. They put this up in the air cleaner in case the diaphragm fails. The fuel right. Don't go into the bilge. Yeah.
I thought that ran back to the gas tank.
No, they run it up to the air filter.
Holy crap. That thing's good.
Yeah, well, the four barrel 327 had a different pump. Has this 3/8 fuel line instead of 5/16.
Is this the right motor? The original motor?
Don't know until you research these numbers right here.
There should be a VIN number on that transmission.
VIN number? No.
Yeah, tail shaft or something on the transmission on the Chevys?
The last one we had was at 59 or 60. And it was on top of the X-frame on the driver's side. Where's the old pump? No fittings in it.
No, it's the old style type.
Joe, you know what that car is worth now? That white one I had.
No, I don't.
The market on that car now, that was like an $80,000 car today. I just hope it ain't a fucking GM replacement. I hope it's not a GM Goodrich motor, that's what I'm worried about.
You wouldn't have these numbers on that cab.
Okay.
GM blocks, replacement blocks, didn't have any stamps.
It's like trying to make a barge bench bass on the river.
Barge
bass. I mean, in their day, you know, they were a quick bar.
Yeah. So they made noise and they moved a little bit.
Yeah.
But the 409 car kind of ball here?
Yeah, right.
They put it in the VIN number. I know in 67, for example, they did not have it in the VIN number. You know, it was a dealer installed package. But this has the console.
Right.
The four-speed console and everything, you know, that designates it as a factory
right.
SS. Here's, they put it in the VIN number. I know in 67, for example, they did not have it in the VIN number. It was a dealer installed package. But this has the console.
Right.
The four-speed console and everything, you know, that designates it as a factory.
The whole interior must have been this bright or something that just faded.
Right. SS. Find out where the block is.
Are the new lights any different or the same exact thing, just different color?
But that other convertible has this bright ass blue carpet in it. The whole interior must have been. I walked off the towers.
Oh, yeah? All of them or just the one?
The first one and the spy who shoots.
Thank you.
You know, that's a pretty neat cut, Bill.
Yeah, look at it real close.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, it's got nice rounded corners. Yeah, see how the boot fits? Like the rubber, see right here where the rubber comes down? It fits.
It's rough.
It's pretty good.
It looks.
Yeah.
Less, yeah, it could be less.
Yeah, because of the way the rubber is, yeah. I would say that
unless
that.
It rotted.
That's original. Yeah. But the motor is definitely not.
Yeah, that's a. Well, the motor's worth something. Man, yeah, that's a. Only 68, 69 had the big journal in it. Those were the.
Yeah.
Bed motors. Probably has two heads. I got the numbers for the heads over there, but a lot of you can't really tell.
Right.
Unless, you know, you take it apart because people are saying, oh, it could be 194.
Could be 202s, yep. That's what it said there on the internet too, Bill. Exact same thing. '68, Bill.
Here's your big hammer in here, Bill.
Oh, my big hammer. All right, fire up, let it warm up.
Saves a ton of money on shipping if it has brakes. Even if we can get some brakes or like, do they have dual masters on these or something?
Everybody, Pete, Iron City Garage here with the 64 Impala SS Convertible. Four-speed car, 327, not the original motor. I was absent in a YouTube video. I was pretty sick while we were working on this car, so guys went ahead and did the brakes on the car. That may seem silly to a lot of you watching the video, but the reason we did that is for shipping. It's pretty inexpensive to do the brakes on any of these old cars, to do them original, so went ahead and did that just so when this car eventually undoubtedly gets shipped to California, that's where the car will end up, in New Mexico or California. Now it has brakes and it likely won't get wrecked or damaged in shipping. It also ships a lot cheaper, so for what it cost me to do the brakes, the customer is going to save a bunch of money in shipping. It's like, instead of paying $1.50 a mile for what they call a non-operational vehicle because it doesn't have brakes, now you're looking at paying about half of that. So it'll be about 70 or 80 cents a mile to go that far. It's a huge savings. Did the brakes. She's running, driving, stopping. We'll walk around the car a little bit here. The car's real straight. Unfortunately, the car's not real solid. So nice straight body panels, all the trims on the car, convertible top mechanisms here. The car is rusty. Car needs, you know, lower quarters. Needs quarters up high here in the trunk. This whole channel kind of rusted off. All the bumpers are on it though. It's not, you know, the car's very complete, but it will need a full restoration. Needs trunk floor, needs quarters, needs floor pans. They're not terrible, but you know, they need replaced. I've had cars that were straight Flintstone cars. You could put your feet on the ground. This car's not that bad. Interior is all present. Center console's there. Just a really nice original car. Looks like it was last on the road in 1978, so been off the road for quite some time. Missing one headlight bezel, but the car runs great. Unfortunately, it's not the original motor. It is a 68 engine that we believe came out of another Impala. So it's a 68 327, but it runs great. It's a really, really strong motor. So if you have one of these cars in your garage, if you've got a convertible Impala rotting away in the woods, you got one in your garage, your neighbor has one, you saw one down the road when you were delivering something, I want to know about it. If you think you could get one bought in the neighborhood off of a neighbor or family member or whatever, you'd be interested in putting me in, I'd love to do it. You can get a hold of me at 412-335-6100. We're interested in 1958 through 1964 Impala hardtops or convertibles, really focusing on the convertibles. Also, fastback Mustangs, trucks and cars like this, all original vehicles, really any condition. Send an email, ironcitygarage@gmail.com, or shoot me photos and a text message at 412-335-6100. We'll see what we can do. Finder's fees always paid, and just fair value is always paid if you're the one selling the vehicle.